of the group stages. Two weekends, as you say, Simon, to shape the outcome of qualification. And both of these teams have been referring to this as a test match all week. For the returning international players, no need to change the mindset at all. Indeed, all the individuals involved today need to be right up on that level.
Well, at least that level. This is high-pressure stuff with the highest level performers ready to perform. Three England greats, that man, Martin Johnson, Delalia and Neil Back, and a whole host of potential lines, but that is for the future. This is the Heineken Cup, and it's Wasps against Leicester.
And for Leicester, the added pressure of having lost to Biarritz and knowing that the gap would be a big one if they went down again today. But equally, just think if Leicester won and the pressure that would heap onto Wasps as Welford Road beckons next weekend. And the French also have to go to Leicester, but first a job to be done here for Martin Johnson and his men. And as is the tradition now, Leicester welcome back plenty of England forwards from international duty. Johnson and Back used to return from national service, not now, but that still leaves Roundtree, White, Moody, Corrie all returning. Lewis Deacon is preferred to Ben Kay at lock. George Shooter starts after a six-week ban. In the backs, Rambinia tries scoring force this season. He failed a late fitness test, so Lloyd starts on the wing. Ollie Smith, though, is over a shoulder problem. And it's experience all the way from Leicester. Spot the weakness in that huddle if you can. And London Wasps have been in a grump all week, smarting after that defeat to Worcester in the English Premiership, and no doubt using that reverse to give the extra edge for this encounter. The double winners had that wake-up call from Birmingham Solihull, didn't they, in the National Cup last season. Maybe another part of the West Midlands has got Wasps going again. But this is a different team from the one they put out last week, with the major influences all restored, and Lawrence Delalio and his side prepare to come out to this full house here in Wickham. Delalio, another England great and former captain like Johnson, leading out the European champions. The Wasps side with big guns back then. Worsley and O'Connor into the back row with Delalio, Lucy on the wing. Stuart Abbott starts, a little bit like Leicester's centre Ollie Smith, not with the games behind him after injury, but highly influential players those two. Matt Dawson has been struggling a bit this week with a calf strain, but he starts too. 10 of the team that took the field for the final in May begin this match. Of course, Dawson not one of them. Then it was Robert Howley at scrum half. And on the bench, Wasps opting for young James Haskell, not Tom Rees. That was their late decision. Leicester had calls to make at hooker, back row and wing. And in the end, it's Cockerell, Will Johnson, Alex Tuilagi. They're all in on the bench after various fitness assessments around the squad. Referee is Nigel Williams. And you might remember he was the man in the middle for last season's epic semi-final at Lansdowne Road. London Wasps went on to win that game and win the title too. And now the holders against the twice winners Leicester. Two clubs with realistic ambitions to go all the way again this year, trying to batter the other one into an early exit. It is the unmissable match of this weekend. Moody for Leicester. Ellis, Goode. Mark van Gisbergen at fullback for London Wasps. That's gone high. Just stumbling on his way through, clashing with a Leicester player, but no infringement there. The referee saw it, and the mark called by Andy Goode, who of course slotted the late conversion to level the Premiership meeting in November between these two. 17 all, but don't use that as any kind of guide.
Now van Gisbergen, a little collision with Johnson, legs tangle there. The Wasps fans thought there was something there, there wasn't. Such an important early opening stages here. Andy Goode's first two strikes were not that impressive. As the boys in the studio said, the two men at 10 are so important today.
Greening throws, oh, he's got all the way over the top and he's found Neil Back, and this is great ball for Leicester. Goode shipping it along first of all, it's already with Lloyd, and it's out now to Ollie Smith, and Ollie Smith is cutting inside, he's got Moody with him, and this could be a dramatic start, and it is! The try was thrown away into Leicester's hands. European hopes rest on such moments.
The quality of the Leicester midfield passing is as good as Phil Greening's throw is bad. The timing of back and good, excellent there. Leon Lloyd from his wing to Ollie Smith round. Such awareness, and the little pop pass out of the tackle to Moody is outstanding. And Lewis Moody, what he does have for a number six is great pace. Van Gisbergen drawn by the excellence of Smith, and then it's Worsley against Moody. Two international sixes, and Worsley, fine tackler, just cannot get to Moody. Thumps the ground in joy. A tremendous start for Leicester.
And now Andy Goode already has another conversion at the Causeway Stadium. Not to level a Premiership match, to give Leicester a 7-point start in the Heineken Cup match. And what a kick that is from Goode, complementing the try. It's London Wasps 0, Leicester Tigers 7. And Phil Greening will be rueing this mistake.
First line out and he goes long, it's the difficult one, but Neil Back's pullback pass is superb. Gibson's hands were sublime there, and Smith drew the man, and from there on it's 7-0. What a start.
And just how the match started, with Moody coming towards his 22 meter line from the restart, this time not the kickoff. It's been lost forward, and Wasps and Delalio, well, they knew they were going to be in a match today, and now, after that kind of start, food for thought, but a chance for the home side to attack. Dawson has the ball, and the forwards get ready to go into the scrum. First line out was critical. What about the first scrum? London Wasps, five stones just about in their favour. Warren Gatland.
Interesting alignment, Alex King right behind the scrum, Van Gisbergen next to him, and a Rinley wide with Tom Voice to the right as you look on. Needs to be a solid scrum here. Dowd and White, so important. Roundtree, he'll want to come in at the side, attack Will Green. It's an area I think Leicester think they might shade the Wasps in the front row.
International props for both sides, Dowd and Green for Wasps, round three, and White for Leicester, and two international scrum halves now. Harry Ellis having broken into the England team. Dawson, the man who had the shirt.
The scrum, you're obliged to go back behind the number 8 feet, not stand in front of it, okay?
Thank you, sir. In the World Cup final, of course, Gummersall of Gloucester on the scene too now, but look at this between these two, and Dawson complaining about being pushed and then giving a push himself into the face of Ellis, and talking of pushing, Leicester driving and shoving London Wasps into the air, and Delalio and Ellis involved now, and this one is cooking.
Well, I must say, Matt Dawson should really have been penalised for shoving Harry Ellis in the face. Dawson was in the wrong, Ellis all over him, and now he's having a go at Delalio. Martin Corey and Delalio. Turn your heaters down. You don't need any heat in the living room for this.
Martin Corey is furious with something that's happened out there. Delalio's shaking his head. There is no love lost at the moment between the two former England squad men.
No, it was handbags. They were involved after the whistle. Nothing started it, nothing finished it.
9 and 8.
Handbag, says Clayton Thomas. Well, it's what you carry in those handbags.
Number 9, sorry. Number 9.
Calm yourself down, Harry. It's not you, mate.
Wait a minute. 8 here. Hey, guys, let's just come in. Just saying, a little bit of handbags after the ball. We're not going to make a huge drama out of this, okay? But discipline is paramount. Yeah. And if you carry on doing things like this, no other option, but we got to go on the touchline. Okay, calm it down. Yep. The original penalty.
Well, I've got to say, Leicester are winning all the early battles, aren't they? They put the screw on in the shove. Ellis stood up to Delalio, and things going very well for Leicester, and Lawrence Delalio, there you can see, just grabbing Ellis to let him know he's on the pitch, but at the moment it's the Tigers who are snarling.
I'm not sure Delalio's words have calmed Corey down. Here we go again. Corey making that line-out ball his. Taken by Shooter. Picked up by O'Connor, but the referee pulls them back for the knock forward. George Shooter there. He's been out for 6 weeks. Johnny O'Connor, of course, making such an impression with Ireland in the autumn international period. Well, Shooter had to sit and watch. There was talk of Shooter being involved with England, but that came to nothing after his indiscretion in the game against Bath. Another penalty here for Leicester at the scrum. And Martin Johnson pulls his men back. He doesn't want any penalty being overturned here. The hard work has been done at that scrum, and the opportunity now can be presented to Goode.
Well, the Leicester pack have disrupted Wasps on the first scrum, and they have got the squeeze on them there. Dowd's popped up there in the end. Johnson in control of the situation. Martin Corey clapping. Oh, this is feisty, and it is a tremendous start for Leicester. Not just the points, but the points being scored psychologically at scrum time.
Captains have a big responsibility out there to channel all of this effort. And Johnson, you could see there, doing his best. Here's Goode. And again, from Andy Goode, the Leicester fly half. It's already 10-0. And Warren Gatland has been saying that his side has been winning, but winning ugly. And this is an ugly and potentially losing start from London Wasps. Long way to go yet, but what a start it is for Leicester. Corey there complaining to the referee. Here's Murphy. And then Moody.
Big start
Moody
for Lewis Moody.
Worsley battle that flanker. What a confrontation there. And this is Goode. Wait there. And Voice. Chance for Voice to run it back at Leicester. And what a threat he was at the tail end of last season. And in the Heineken Cup in particular, Tom Voice. And Leicester were there very quickly to make that tackle. And they've got the turnover. And the ball was held up.
Well, Tom Voice went in very high there, and that's why he's turned over. You can see Wasp, in terms of action areas, dominating, but that's just because we've been dwelling around with scrums in their own half. Leicester looking sharper and more physical at the moment. The only stat that matters after 8 minutes is top of your screen.
Delalio trying to stop this drive now and needing some help as Leicester went up that blind side. Half charge down, falls for Wasps, nearly to Burkitt, didn't quite catch it, but it didn't go forward. This is Dawson, out to King, missed out Orinley and given to Abbott, and Lucy of Wasps and England. Good work by Leon Lloyd, and they're making sure the ball went out. And Leon Lloyd tried to take the quick one. Not sure it was Leicester ball. The touch judge and the referee were on the scene and decided that it was.
Well, I've got to say, Josh Lucy was incredibly high on Harry Ellis there. Really edgy. This is Leon Lloyd pushing him into touch.
Well, it was Lloyd who put the ball out, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, but I tell you, what was interesting was when Leicester tried to move the ball quickly, Lucy flew in on Harry Ellis and Lloyd was right there. It's very interesting as well. Ollie Smith, international outside centre, is playing left wing. Leon Lloyd is playing outside centre.
Another penalty for Leicester. Well, Wasps got the put into the scrum. They should have had the line out. And Craig Dowd, the man who made a return from his Achilles problem against Calvisano in this competition this season.
You may have missed it, but that's twice a penalty. Okay, once the hooker. We must stay in and stay up, please.
The former All Black who missed the final last season because of that injury, knowing that he's in a right royal battle this afternoon up front against Julian White, and warned quite clearly there by Nigel Williams. And Andy Goode, not for the first time in this match or his career, striking that ball so sweetly at the touchline.
Very important for Goode to keep his cool. It's very feisty out there. I'm really impressed with the way Leicester are playing, right on the edge and not quite stepping over at the moment. A great start.
Shooter to Corey and then Ellis and Goode, and through the middle they go. Gibson's got it again. Service out to Lloyd. This could be quite unbelievable. a gem!
No crossing. I saw it clearly. No crossing.
Brilliant try. Leicester, when they played in the Premiership, carved Wasps up with a decoy line in the middle. And they have done it again. It's a wonderful score. Tail of the line out. Look how flat. Ollie Smith is the decoy, arms in the air. Gibson to Lloyd, and then Murphy has the pace to get there. Beautiful decoy lines. Ollie Smith from out to in. He doesn't interfere with any tackler. I think that is a magnificent try for Leicester.
Murphy's try. And once more, Goode trying to convert from out wide, from the other side of the pitch this time. Well, for Leicester, unless something goes wrong with a Goodness conversion, but they will not be complaining. 15 points in front and a try to save a Stewart.
Ollie Smith, the decoy line there, then the outside line from Gibson, and there's your hole, and then the try.
Deacon won the restart, it was retrieved by Moody.
Watch your feet.
And it's all Leicester and London Wasps, the champions. Shell shot.
You're all offside.
But that offside from the kick from Ellis has given Wasps a chance to get back in this match. And they're going for the post.
Well, it isn't often you say after 13 minutes that this kick is absolutely vital, but at 0-15 against the pumped-up Tigers, who are on the edge, but on the right side of that edge, this is such a kick for Mark van Gisbergen. Nothing has gone Wasps' way. Everything has worked for Leicester. They need points. They just need to get their hands on the ball and just will take the sting out of the Leicester game. Leicester are playing right on the brink and they're comfortable with it. Wasps have not come out composed. They need to compose themselves.
The kicker is Mark van Gisbergen. Not Alex King, it's van Gisbergen with the job today, and he makes sure that the flags go up. That was a cool kick. Gets Wasps going, but they've still got an awful lot of going to do.
They're the European champions. You don't forget their comeback against Munster in a hurry, and they're well in this game, but they did need those 3 points. Important and immediate riposte.
Good restarts down the middle. Ollie Smith chasing Moody too. Good challenge from both of them.
Great kick as well from Andy Goode.
Plenty of hang. This is King.
Advantage over.
And that's a good kick too from Alex King at fly half. He's been struggling with his foot injury, but okay today. There's a couple of drop goals against Biarritz, making a difference on that day, but London Wasps knew that it wasn't just going to be about Biarritz this group. The Tigers too, three teams in one group, all feeling that they can win the trophy. There's going to be some damage in this pool. And of course, whoever goes through will find life a little bit easier in the quarterfinals because of the sides that have gone out. If two go out, of course, two might qualify. So much about the qualification will be decided over the next weekend and this one. This is now van Gisbergen on the counter-attack. Neil Back is there quickly to tackle, and he's leading the charge in that back row, and Moody isn't far behind him.
In the side.
Here's Lucy. And the referee spotting a player coming in at the side, conceding another penalty there, Leicester. Just inside the Wasps half.
Well, they got the benefit there of a very poor kick from Andy Goode, but real problems for Wasps once again with that line out. The drive was so powerful from Leicester. There you see Roundtree and White double ganging as they so often do in the tackle, but Wasps have got an issue here because they are just not getting to Leicester at scrum or line out at the moment, and it was only a very poor kick from Goode that gave Wasps the opportunity. That's a good kick from King, but now Greening has to really settle down. He's got to hit his man.
purposeful stride. Wasps move forward to this line-out, a vital line-out. Vital for Greening's confidence, as you say. Let's see what happens now. And it's a mess, but it's a mess because of some pulling down, says the referee. Once again, it gets tasty up front. And this within range. And they're going for the post again to whittle away at that early Leicester lead.
Well, quite interestingly, 20 or so metres behind Mark van Gisbergen, Matt Dawson is down, and he's been down a little while at the moment. He's not looking happy. I think he's up for the battle. But he took one on the calf there.
Well, he's been struggling with that calf this week, hasn't been in full training, and Warren Gatland might be forced into thinking about a change here. Harvey Billion is the replacement scrum half. He started against Bath in the Premiership win at the Rec and played very well in that match, but of course Dawson, a big match player, and they'll want to work on him now, as they do. Van Gisbergen already successful with one penalty, a little bit closer in now. Successful again. Economy of effort from Mark van Gisbergen. 14 points before today in the Heineken Cup this season. Six more now. Billion waiting to come on. Should he get the call? Dawson still on the floor.
Well, that is Jordan Murphy's try nullified, plus a point. And Dawson, he'll want to get back, but the first 17 minutes or so. Well, Harry Ellis has been all over him, clinging to him like ivy. And Dawson is looking a bit roughed up.
And he needs to get across to this ruck quickly as the London Wasps scrum half, and he's not moving at all freely, but moving in one direction certainly was Julian White there, and Austin Healy's got across, and Corrie's waiting. Corrie's got it, and Corrie has scored. This is turning into a Leicester dream.
Well, the virtue of Austin Healy again. There aren't that many wings who can just pop up from nowhere, see the space as quickly as Healy did. What a Wasps doing, I don't know. But Healy's execution is excellent. He doesn't put too much height, so that doesn't give Van Gisbergen time. Corrie, he's so big and strong, and he drives low. You've seen him doing it for England the last 2 weeks. Look at the body angle now. Bit of a fumble, then control. And the drive through the tackle of Lucien van Gisbergen. Little forearm from van Gisbergen, but Corrie won't even have felt it. Wasps asleep and Leicester sting again.
Moody, Murphy, Corrie, already try scorers. And Andy Goode adds another 2 points from that same spot where he was successful before. London Wasps 6, Leicester Tigers 22, and we were talking about Wasps and van Gisbergen wiping out the Murphy try. Well, now Corrie, with the aid of Goode, have wiped out the van Gisbergen penalties with a point in addition to.
Still in!
Ellis to Goode.
Well, this try's interesting. You'll see now spotlighted Lucy, who loves to rush in from midfield. Look how close and how narrow he is. Healy thinks, no, you're too wide. Corrie's picked it out. They've gone over the top of the rush defence, out to in, and Leicester have conquered them aerially. Superb play from Healy, but Leicester worked that one well.
That's great vision from Healy and the execution on the kick. And remember, at the end of last season, Healy scored a couple of tries when Leicester had a romp here in the Premiership, and they are producing that kind of form today in this match.
Well, they identified Wasps' defence and they worked out a way to turn Wasps' aggression into their own advantage. It's really smart training field stuff. Pat Howard will be so pleased with that.
The maul went to the deck. You must come in round the back, not in at the side.
There's been a stream of penalties in this match, more like a river, in fact.
I think torrent would be the word after these first 20 minutes.
Or torrid.
Yeah.
Here's King. that left boot to squeeze it down the line, which he does. That's pretty good from that angle.
It's very good.
One thing for sure, this game has not meandered in the first 20.
Smile from Pat Howard. Thumbs up to
the gap, please, boys.
At the moment. Talk about rivers and streams. It's Leicester who are swimming along, but a long time to go. It's all happened very quickly, hasn't it? And that's, in a way, Leicester's problem. There's still an hour to play.
Oh, I think it's a problem they'll be happy with. Yeah. The other thing, you know, we've talked about all the permutations. They've got an hour to score one try, to already get one bonus point. And for Wasps to win is one thing. To stop Leicester getting another bonus point looks almost impossible from here.
And Pat Howard said this week that he wanted 9 points from the two games. And maybe he was thinking about, you know, bonus points being elsewhere. But to get the bonus point in the bag at the causeway, well, that puts a different complexion on this pool again. Fascinating stuff as Greening goes to the tail and gets his man this time in Delalio. But the Tigers driving. But they'll need to be firm in defence here, because London Wasps are in a position to possibly strike.
Back foot.
Dawson has a foot in his way, it's cleared out of the way, and then it's King to Worsley. Worsley turning to try and find Ridley. Yeah. Another penalty. Now, the referee might decide that this run of penalties has stretched his patience. It's certainly stretching the patience of the Wasps players.
You can't do that.
So much at stake here.
I've seen the offence. I've seen the offence. Please, just take them back, Skipper. Take them back. Skip, just take them back, please. Okay. Just keep calm for a moment. I saw the original offence, which was the scrum half playing it on the floor.
Play that penalty.
I'm going to have it. Yeah. You tackled him, scooping it off the floor.
It is time for the sin bin, and it's Harry Ellis who's been sent there by Nigel Williams. Wasps have got the extra man. Can they make it pay?
Well, he's been on the edge for 20, just gone over it. Just before then, you know, Graham Rowntree deliberately put his boot in the way to slow it down. Didn't slow it enough. Ellis plays it on the four, nicks it from Joe Worsley. 14 against 15, and Wasps really must score from here. But I think Leicester will attack this line-out.
Having made that tackle, Ellis has to make an attempt to roll away. Didn't he play the ball?
Wait, we had
Let's go again, says the referee.
We go again.
Builds the pressure on Greening, of course, having got it right first time.
Yeah, he doesn't want to waste too many of those throws, does he? And it was interesting, Leicester didn't compete there. Johnson setting himself for the drive.
Gets it right the second time. Burkett used.
Look at the Leicester drive, though.
Instant, wasn't it? As soon as they were able to drive, they got into it. But still with Wasps, and Dawson to King. Here's a Ridley, haven't seen him yet, this big presence in the Wasps centre, having such a good season.
No, calm down.
Ball rolled forward,
scrum
off a Leicester hand, so Wasps to put in. 7 points here would change the look of the match again.
Wait.
Good attacking position as well. Abbott goes on to the wing. Josh Lucy becomes a second full back. There you go, Lucy.
Delalio to Worsley. Right in centre field now. There will be options both ways here for Dawson. He looks around, he finds Craig down. Good tackling from Corrie. Ball back with Dawson. Out to King. Van Gisbergen again. Now Abbott's got it. Boyce was waiting. Probably the right decision not to go to the winger. They were running out of space, but they weren't running out of men. Neil Back is trying to get this back on the Leicester side, but it's still with Wasps, and they can see that line. It's agonisingly close. Dawson goes for it. In goes Boyce to act as scrum half.
Pull him in.
Do they have the manpower to take this over? Shaw is looking. Will he give it a go, or will he leave it for somebody else? O'Connor's there. Dowdy's coming back around. O'Connor's got it! O'Connor against the fly half. Good, and that's good strength from Good. Great defence, in fact, from the fly half. Still with Wasps. Tucked into that corner. Dawson again. Out to King. Missed out Delalio. Men on this side. Ridley gets it on. Couldn't find Abbott. Did find Lucy. Lucy with the handoff. Oh, this match is unbelievable. It's absolutely terrific.
Fantastic handoff from Lucy. because you felt the Wasps handling in field had blown the opportunity. It wasn't sharp passing. King's cutout ball is very good, but Arindley's ball is a poor one. But then Lucy, with that upper body strength, is through Daryl Gibson. The former All Black will not be pleased, but Lucy is so strong. It's not a good pass from Arindley, but how about that for a fend? Half a dummy for Ollie Smith, and then the full treatment for Daryl Gibson. And the European champions, as we knew they would be, come back at Leicester.
Here's Van Gisbergen as the ground calms down. What a magic kick again. He's just right in the zone, isn't he? He knows exactly what he's doing. It's beautiful kicking from Van Gisbergen. And look at Lucy. He was hurt by that score from Corrie. He knew he'd been caught on his wing. You could see it in his body language for a couple of minutes after that try. He was an international player who'd been exposed and he didn't like it, and now he's come back with the right answer along with his team, and that 7 points has come, and it does look different, doesn't it? Now King again. O'Connor. Delalio, good ball off to Arindley. Lloyd is tracking him. Arindley comes back inside. Dawson, King, behind Ollie Smith, and Jordan Murphy trying to get there. Haven't seen too much of Murphy so far. I know he scored a try, but you know what I mean? He's going over the top, and when we do see him, it's normally brilliant. And Johnson throwing himself on the floor now. Andy Goode has seen something on this side. It's Corrie again, and he was charging to take that.
Come back! Let's come forward!
Well, Andy Goode had a kick to nothing there because he knew he had the advantage. An advantage can't really be overruled with just the one kick.
Time out!
Corrie's so strong there. More a touch of Aussie rules about this man. Really rising high there. And Andy Goode has been very composed as well. Andy Goode has had a good start. He was poor in Biarritz. Him and Ellis didn't function. But the Leicester halfbacks, even though Ellis is in the bin, have started well. It's the problem for Wasps, isn't it, Miles? Because it looks like Matt Dawson is not going to be carrying on.
Wait a minute, please. Trainer's still on. Time on.
And remember, Peter Richards, who, of course, was a scrum half before he became a centre this season and went back to scrum half against Worcester, is away with England and the Sevens at the moment. Now, Harry Ellis, another scrum half off the field, and Leicester conceding points in the absence of their number nine. Healy naturally standing in that role. He's played many times before for club and country.
We're up in the front row, both teams.
We heard Dawson was heading off, but he doesn't want to go, does he?
Stay. Use it.
Healy. Little chip down the blind side, chasing himself. And Boyce needed all of his pace there because Healy was on him. And where's Van Gisbergen going? The answer is almost up to halfway. What a run by Mark Van Gisbergen on the counter-attack. Well supported by O'Connor. Wasps still have it. Dawson to Abbott. He's knocked on.
They weren't offside.
And had Abbott been able to take that, Phil Greening was waiting, Lucy was there too, Worsley and Arindley, and it was all started by Mark Van Gisbergen, beating two men and away.
It could have been a try, all because of Van Gisbergen's bravery to counter-attack from deep.
We're up again in the front row, you're both going up, guys. Hang on, stand up, there's blood here, stand up.
Healy, a sort of abrasive Peter Pan, of course. He's already caused problems from 10. He's in at 9 now. He's such a good player to have in your team, isn't he?
Use it! That ball's out!
Dawson trying to put a boot in there to disrupt Healy. Lucy calls for the mark this time. And then slices horribly and gives the initiative straight back to Leicester. And by his own high standards, and they are really high, as high as you can get, Josh Lucy will be more than gutted.
He'll be disgusted with that. He's a great athlete, physical presence, but just every now and again you do get the feeling he doesn't control the flame that burns there. Now Leicester in control of the line-out. And it's Corey again.
Every time to Corey it seems, and when you think that Johnson and Deacon are there as options, but Corey, another major line-out force, as he was for England over the last few weeks.
He's having a terrific spell.
Release it! Watch your feet!
Healy, good. Well, he tried to use his weight, and he did in the end. How did he get that going? He seemed to have been stopped, Andy Goode. But then, the penalty.
And the tackler did.
Well, Johnny O'Connor, international number 7, playing for Ireland, regarded by many as a Lions' potential Test Open side, was marched backwards by Andy Goode.
Held onto the ball, though, didn't he, on the floor, and that was the problem. But the problem for O'Connor was the use of Goode's strength, and now Wasco quickly with the tap, and Abbott chips. And Arindley's got there in no time at all to put pressure on Murphy, and it's dropped by Lloyd, and what a good chase that was. Boyce went with Arindley, but it was the centre, Ayula Arindley, who got there first and fully justified the effort that he put into that speedy run upfield.
Well, you've just got to chase any cause, and you can make a lost one, a 1-1, and that's what happened there. Jordan Murphy, so composed most of the time, saw that pass dip away, and Leon Lloyd will be annoyed that he dropped it.
Ellis about to come out of the sin bin, but Wasps still have this extra man. Can they make it tell for a second time? Dawson, King, going for the drop goal. Charged down by the thigh of Goode. It's fallen for Wasps, though. Advantage being played for a knock-on from Leicester. Oh, coming through offside maybe there against Corey. Had a nervous glance at the referee. King is put on his backside, and the referee goes back for the knock-on, yes. Ball was out when Corey came through.
Wasps bench wanted Dawson off, and he just decided, I think, he's not going to go. Here's Andy Goode putting the pressure on Alex King, and because of the deflection, well, that means it's fair game for all. We saw yesterday Perpignan score a quite amazing try from a deflection, where Manny Edmonds just ran through and scored. There, Wasps gained 20 metres.
Delalio again, here comes Lucy off his wing, using his power. Dawson, King, Abbott was the decoy, Arindley. Plenty of power there too. Important challenge from Leon Lloyd, and look at Lloyd grimacing on the corner of that row. Greening, slipping at that vital moment, he was starting to move. Dawson again, Van Gisbergen, O'Connor, and still the Irishman, supported by Delalio. Dawson to Burkitt, but there might have been a little gap in behind Leicester there, but it was closed quickly. Here's King again, couldn't locate either Arindley or Greening, and Ellis is coming back onto the field as we approach half-time.
Dawson continues to hobble, and you said there might have been a slight gap, and you're right. And a problem for Wasps is Matt Dawson's great strength is the ability to see that gap and the acceleration to go. Now you can see he's not right with his calf, and with a calf injury that's suspect like this, Matt Dawson is not going to be punching any holes there. And if he's not right, then frankly he just becomes an organizer, a distributor, a chipper, and an experienced presence, and it's a decision that needs making here.
Maybe not by Dawson, because going through Dawson's mind will be the fact that he's not in the England setup anymore, for reasons we all know, and this kind of fixture today is filling the void in his rugby life.
Oh yes, I mean, he's not going to want to go off. He's hugely committed player. I see Leicester making a lot of tackles.
Here comes Shaw at that line out. Dawson, King, Worsley, penalty, should be 3 points. No, Now, what did we get to at one stage? 22 points to 6.
Guys. The difference.
That's all you do.
22-16 if this goes
please.
Over.
Tough enough
the way
as it
Mark
is
Van Gisbergen has been kicking. And I don't think there are many people in this ground that will bet against Van Gisbergen missing this shot.
Now Leicester just starting to suffer for the penalties that, I must say, through their great years of winning trophies, they've been prepared to give away in their 22 in the danger zone. And with Van Gisbergen kicking like this, they've chipped their way back in. One powerful handoff and a six-point gap after 36 minutes is absolutely nothing. Wasps have been in third gear most of this season. They started this match in third gear, now they're in overdrive and we have a game.
And Van Gisbergen trying to get his mind in neutral. Tallest man on the field, Mark Van Gisbergen at that moment.
Well, they've risen to the challenge. Leicester have thrown down an almighty gauntlet from the East Midlands. Johnson and co have come here. They want to conquer, and Delalio's men are saying, right, we're going to rise to this one.
I'm standing here watching all of this passion between the two teams and the supporters. It's a marvellous occasion, and it's Boyce and Van Gisbergen not wanting to get themselves in a hole there. Very canny, isn't he, with those restarts, Andy Goode. Got great skill as he hangs that ball in the air and he switches the angles and he asks questions all the time.
Stay.
Dawson. At times it seems Dawson's hardly able to stand, but he got his kick in there over the shoulder.
Shaking his head, he's in pain, but he's a tough hombre. He's gone through the pain barrier before. But if he is hobbling on that one leg, Wasps have lost a very important attacking weapon as well.
The top two in the English Premiership. And two of the favourite teams for this Heineken Cup again this season. Not straight at the line out. Now what's happening in there?
Leave, guys! Guys, look, please! Please.
they're scrapping over that handbag we were hearing about earlier.
Okay.
Early Christmas sales.
That handbag that's carrying a brick inside. Yeah, that one.
Yeah, pink spangled one. I've seen Martin Johnson carrying it around Leicester.
Penalty for the Leicester front row. And look at Johnson go to his men, his front line, and say, that belongs to you.
Well, England's two outstanding props at the moment. Rowntree, who is getting better with age, and Julian White.
Skipper.
He has got his eyes on New Zealand, and right now he's got his eyes on a New Zealander, Craig Dowd.
Sure not to have happened accidentally, or let's hope that it did, OK?
It
because
yeah.
There's something in the eye. If okay. I see it, you know the consequences
right.
of it.
6-1,
OK?
Well, Graham Rowntree moments ago went down injured and he was hurt genuinely. That happened about 5 minutes ago. And but you wouldn't have known, he was straight back into the heat of this. And just like Dawson, these players will have to be carried off the field.
Well, the brain is engaged to play rugby, but it's been switched off to pain. All brain, no pain. That's the sort of match we got here. And Graham Rowntree, well...
No, 3 minutes.
He can live with that, but he's not very happy about what caused it to come out.
He's making his 50th appearance in the Heineken Cup today and gets a European Rugby Elite Award for that, and is the first Leicester player, the first Englishman to get to that level of service in this competition. And Graham Rowntree, for many years now, a loyal servant, his favourite club. Here's Andy Goode. And he just cannot be pushed off his line today.
Well, we've got a high quality of goal kicking that has matched this game. King goes fast on the restart, but Healy's brain, as ever, razor sharp.
He's switched on all right, and he tries a little swerve on the outside, but he gets the penalty in the end.
Roll away.
It's Abbott again having made the tackle.
You tackled him and then you fell the other way as well. You've got to get away from him.
Yeah, try to get on the wrong side to prevent that ball coming back on the Leicester side. The referee was in good position. Andrew Williams has had to be one of the fittest players or officials out there. He's been running around like a mad thing for this match.
I say this for Nigel Williams. Whenever we see him, we end up with cracking games, and that's not always just a coincidence.
And this one could have gone badly wrong today.
Oh, well, the first 5 minutes with all that edge.
Here's Gibson, just behind him, but it didn't matter. He still carried. And here's Johnson doing exactly the same with all in front of him. Good pass, flat pass out to Murphy, and that was silky, two on to Smith. Leon Lloyd is trying to help him. The ball is there for back. Back the scrum half that time, then it's good. Johnson's hanging out in centre field. Austin Healy knew the tackle was coming from Dawson, his great mate. Roundtree to Ellis to Murphy.
Away tackle!
Everybody involved in this match.
Advantage.
O'Connor now. Advantage being played as the ball was knocked on.
Advantage over!
Alex King, he's put too much on that. Lucy fancied winning that race. Still might, no. Ball's there first. Goob was struggling. Josh Lucy got a shove as well, and the referee's given a penalty. And that is a silly penalty to give away. I mean, previously, Leicester were giving penalties to help their defensive aims, but that time, ball was dead, shove in the back. Didn't need to happen. Three points on a plate.
God, I tell you what, I'm not so certain about that. The nature of that game. Look, he's hardly touched him. That is not a penalty. There is no way on earth that is a penalty. I mean, Matt Dawson shoved Harry Ellis in the face and didn't get penalised. Watch this now. It's nothing. He's not. There's no intent there. Josh Lucy appeals and he gets that one. I think that's a very tough call against Gooden Leicester.
There's Van Gisbergen. The referee thought it was a penalty. Was certainly did. And here's Van Gisbergen. To land another 3 points. Inevitable. That's half time. That's a debating point too. And there were many of them in that first half. In a breathtaking half of Heineken Cup rugby. It's left everybody with a neutral stance, with a smile on their face. And it's up to those men in the middle representing Wasps and Leicester to go on and win it in the second half. And you just do not know who is going to fall on the right side of the fence, Stuart.
Well, one thing about which there is no debate is the quality of this match. It has been magnificent from first minute to 40th. We were hoping to get something stepping up from the first few weeks. We're up there at test level. We're above most tests. This is a tremendous contest.
So half-time, London Wasps 19, Leicester 25.
Year for England.
Some marvellous innings from Graham Gould.
England had their backs against the wall.
England have won the series.
This is spectacular. Harmison and Pogard
are really ripping through New Zealand here.
Everything's gone England's way.
McClintock has got his man again.
That's it. England have completed
4-0 whitewash to West Indies.
And now to South Africa. The England Tour in association with Stan James, coming soon live only on Sky Sports.
The new Citroen C4, alive with technology.
The PlayStation can spell great danger for the golfers. To survive, they must overcome the threat of enemies, like the porn stars. A lone golfer. match for 3 feet females. For others, surviving on the PlayStation is a moment to be savored. HP PhotoSmart cameras and printers. It's now brilliantly simple to click, print, invent.
Coming up on Tuesday, live coverage of this year's Varsity match. We get underway at 1 o'clock on Sky Sports 1. But here at the Causeway Stadium, you cannot take your eye off this game for a minute. It's living up to its billing and then some. It's just about had everything already. Leicester have been ruthless in their finishing. Three outstanding scores, but you know Wasps would not lie down. A dreadful start for the home side, but the boot of Mark van Gisbergen has kept them in touch. 6 points in it at the moment. Match facts reflect Leicester's indiscipline. Too many penalties by the Tigers within range of their own post. Nigel Williams not afraid to raise that arm, and he's had to as well, because this one is simmering.
It sure is. It's a great match. I mean, the level of intensity out there is enormous, and there's certainly a lot of referees out there at the moment. But, you know, just Leicester, I think, started very well. They were gifted their first try by a poor line out from Wasp. But their other tries have come from just some greatly executed homework that they've done on the training pitch on how to break down Wasp's defence. Wasps have come back very, very well, mainly due to Leicester giving away a lot of silly penalties for indiscipline.
As we expected, the intensity is mostly of a test match, you'd think,
well,
at times.
Well, it is, isn't it? You know, you build it up so much and so much, and sometimes it can be a damp squib. But today, you know, what a fantastic first 40 minutes. The Leicester really did come here. Pat Howard has been doing some great things, as Mike said, I think, in the closed week to try and work out how Wasps play. But they've come out and they really, really shook Wasps in that first 40.
Do you think Wasps, when they came out, they weren't quite up for it as much as Leicester were?
No, I think mentally we were, and we probably played the game several times than I had the night before, because we didn't start well physically. Obviously, Leicester have done the analysis on us, in fairness to our defence. They broke us once with a kick-in and then the pass behind, and when Georgia Murphy scored, they've done their homework, but thankfully Leicester allowed us back in the game now, and hopefully we'll start a little bit better second half.
Let's run you through all the first half tries then. Four in all, three for the away side. We'll start with the Lewis Moody effort, Michael.
Yeah, once again, poor line-out throw there from Watson. This is Leicester have really just spun the ball. Beautiful hands from Gibson there. Great finish, but look at Lewis Moody here. What a great line from a flanker. But look who he's tackled by, Worsley. I mean, that's just the start of the battle.
But I think it's fantastic from Ollie Smith. He knew, he's come in and almost took two guys out, and that's the difference between those two. You know, Lewis Moody has got a little bit more pace than Joe Worsley, but again, a fantastic move started by
Neil Back. That put them 7-0 up, then the boot of Andy Goo put them 10-0 up. Was there a hint of crossing there?
I don't think so. No, yes. I think obviously our defence, our line speed, we just missed the tackle, and you know, they had an overlap with Jordan Murphy getting in.
He didn't take anyone out.
He doesn't take anyone out, does he?
I think it's just a very well executed move. Very good timing on the pass. The ball was not behind anybody. I just think it was a fantastic move and a great finish by Murphy.
Not interfering with play,
this
they think.
Great.
Martin Corey.
This is just great. I mean, you know, Austin Healey, as Stuart said in commentary, just steps in to fly half, puts a kick over, and Corey just waits his time, let the ball bounce, good score.
It's an area where Leicester are actually winning it here, is in terms of the kickoffs. And that last try by Corey showed that. But this is where Wasps came back. Healy, great palm off. And this is where Harry Ellis went to the sin bin and actually brought Wasps back into the game.
Tactically, what needs to change from the Wasps perspective? Rob?
We need to control our set piece. I think the scrum, in particular Julian White, has given us a hard time, and we need to show up the scrum to give Matt and Alex a platform to form. Our line-out has got slowly better, apart from that first line-out. I think that we put pressure on Leicester's line-out, but our scrum is proving the problem at the moment, and we need to scrummage better second half.
Yeah, I think one of the key issues in the second half is to both sides, whoever keeps their emotions under control the best will go a long way to winning this game, because they're giving away a lot of penalties. Both sides are guilty of that, so who can settle down, keep a hold of the ball and play a bit of rugby will probably be in front at the end of the day.
I hate to remind you, all three of you said Wasps at the moment. Yeah. They're trailing at the moment by 6 points, 25-19, the half-time score here. Pick a winner, though. This game is a cracker. Second half is coming next.
Mr. Bullock. Now you see wrongs everywhere and bullying you feel called to remedy.
I'm asking for your help.
Deadwood, the finale. Tuesday at 10, exclusive to Sky One.
The new ZR and ZS from MG, now with £1,000 deposit contribution. Life's too short not to. The Sharp Aquos LCD TV. True colour is the key.
At PC World, we've a great new replacement for your family PC. The high-performance Packard Bell EasyNote H5 laptop at a breakthrough price of only $799 with our fastest ever mobile Intel Pentium 4 processor 538. Plus a recordable DVD, massive memory, a simply sensational Diamond View screen and a high-tech graphics card. Great gaming and so much more for only $799 at PC World.
Today's 4400 returnee.
He disappears, the killings stop. He came back, they started again.
Is yesterday's serial killer.
They sent him back enhanced.
The 4400 tonight at 9, exclusively on Sky One.
Round 4 of the Heineken Cup next weekend, and it's even busier for us. One game on the Friday from 7 is Bourgois against Leinster. That's on Sky Sports 2. And 4 games on the Saturday for you. From 12:30, Ulster against Stade Francais, Toulouse against Northampton, Munster against Cast, and then Perpignan against the Dragons. And on the Sunday, Clonakilty against Glasgow, followed by the return fixture at Welford Road, Leicester against London Wasps. So the interval at the Causeway Stadium, undoubtedly the best half of the tournament so far. Leicester it is with their noses in front, but only by 6. More of the same, please, and we're in for a thriller. Back to Stuart and to Miles.
Oh, yes, Simon, more of the same, please. You know, it's made all the more exciting this weekend because we've got next weekend to look forward to, and part two, and the complexity of this match increased because it's being sort of weaved into the pattern of next weekend, isn't it?
Yes, and I know, and Bieritz thrown into the equation as well, watching this, thinking, what result do we want? I mean, it's impossible. There's so much at stake here, but Leicester will know that their dreadful showing in Bieritz would be totally nullified to the good if they can hang on to this lead. And for Wasps, their European crown will be falling off their heads should they lose today.
And it's about history as well, because Wasps, of course, going into this season's tournament as champions, and Leicester, former champions themselves on two occasions and losing finalists as well. And it's about the future too, because so many of these players, in Delalio's case and Johnson's case, they're playing for that wonderful final chapter to their career with their clubs. But for others, they're competing for international places, both within their countries and also looking at the Lions as well. So it's the past, it's the future, it's the present, it's everything. It's an intoxicating cocktail. And it's Leicester who start this second half, having gone into that big lead and having seen London Wasps, as we sort of knew they would, come back at them. But not enough at the moment to be in front. Here's King. And the skill factor has been very high today, but there have been one or two slice kicks. Well, Alex King, the latest to fall foul of that.
I'm just thinking about the cleverness of the restart, the elevation from Andy Goob, the chase from Lewis Moody that pins Wasp backwards, and King, the kicker, is in the middle of the pitch, so he's got a long way to go to touch, hence the slice. That's really smart play from the Tigers.
And the first half started with a Wasp defence and an error. which cost them dear. And now Leicester trying to do the same at the start of this second half as Andy Goode finds that man mounting in Martin Corrie. What a first half he had. Now Goode is going for the chip in behind, and it was well covered and picked up by Will Green, who then kicks, and Johnny O'Connor, and his opposite number, Neil Back. O'Connor didn't stay on his feet, went straight down on Back. Too tempting, couldn't resist.
The follies of youth there. The man who would be the Lions 7 against the man who has been. I don't think Neil Back would have fancied a nasty bounce there, because O'Connor's pretty quick. And I think Back, as the years advance, likes to be at closer quarters. There's Will Green with a not particularly cultured right boot. And Back goes to ground, and O'Connor off his feet. Naive.
Not culture, but pretty effective there from Green. It was a fine pickup, and he did well for his side in an unusual position. Man who has so much experience, of course. 150 English Premiership appearances for Wasps. He went to that mark against Leicester in November.
Knocked down by Black!
And here is Neil Back coming through the middle, but
there was a bit of obstruction by Black.
The referee has blown the whistle.
By Leicester going and through. We can't play on. We come back for the first one. Knock on by Black in the tackle. Green ball.
All explained by Nigel Williams.
Crouch and hold, please.
First knock on from London Wasps. And then after the advantage, some obstruction from Leicester. So it's a scrum. Corrie Ellis. Goode. Again that chip. Van Gisbergen. We've seen what he can do in this match again on counter-attack ball. He gobbles it up, he loves it. Delalio, good pass, out to King. It should go out, it does. Leicester not forced to play it. And Corrie and Goode were policing that ball over the line. Alex King showing control at fly half. Referee says play on as the ball is thrown infield. But it's with Wasps now, and Dawson to King. That one certainly didn't work for Leicester. This is Abbott. Leicester slice open the defence.
Release!
Nickname of the silent assassin, Stuart Abbott, coming back after injury. That shoulder problem that he suffered on the England tour.
Well, I don't think Martin Johnson will be particularly impressed with Andy Goode and Martin Corrie here. Corrie in particular thinks, well, it's on. And it's fine, it is on, but if you're going to take a risk like that, you've got to make it yours. Tom Voice gets between the two Tigers, and suddenly Wasps have a scrum 25 metres out under the sticks.
The skipper finds Lucy, who finds somehow a way through all of that mess. And then it's picked up by O'Connor, and there was a gap. Dawson again, King, back into the traffic. A chance that time to move it wide, but the result for Wasps is a good one. It's a penalty, and it's Van Gisbergen to step forward again. Surely
make a decision, make a quicker effort to get away, please. 12
Gibson, the man who was penalised.
Penalties are starting to hurt Leicester. 22-6, about, you feel, about to become 22-25, and 9 conceded, but the key is where. 7 in their own half, and with the eagle-eyed Mark Van Gisbergen there, cool as you like, kicking. That is costing them an awful lot of points.
He hasn't put a foot wrong today, Van Gisbergen, and it shouldn't be the kiss of death for him. This is normally shut-your-eyes territory for him. And it is again. And it's London Wasps who get the first points of this second half. And we're almost back to parity.
Admirable temperament, you know, Van Gisbergen. That's what impressed me at the semi-final and final stage of the Heineken Cup. Started this season badly, but the bigger the occasion, the better this guy plays. Johnson shakes his head. He's letting Wasps trickle their way back in.
He's got now 17 points in this match, Van Gisbergen. Better organisation there at the restart from London Wasps, and they are being tested by Andy Goode's kicking at that restart. And now it's Leicester being tested by Alex King, the other fly half, who goes for the kick and charge. Boyce is trying to get there. Healy gave him a little bit of a shoulder, and Andy Goode now in defence gets the ball out. And London Wasps have made a storming start to this second period.
Well, simply superb stuff from Alex King. What composure. Deep in his own territory, he saw the gap, sliced through Martin Johnson, knows he's got no support, doesn't want to kick it out. The chase puts Good under pressure, the slice, and Wasps again have territory.
Grinning throws. No mistake this time, Delalio. Again, a good drive from Leicester at that line out. But it's still with Wasps. Dawson will choose to use it now. Well, he won't, because the advantage was being played and he takes another penalty. An attempt to pull it down. Number six is Lewis Moody. Martin Johnson wonders why.
Number six went to deck and tried to collapse it, prevent them going forward. We've had one penalty there, we've had another here. You know what's coming next time.
It's a fair call. Delalio saying fair call. Johnson cannot shut up that time, and he's lost another 10 metres. Now, will it change the Wasps decision?
Try line, please.
Don't think so. Van Gisbergen is staying put. He's not moving. Delalio just had a little word. We're not going to be tempted into the little chip into the corner and then the catch and dry. Van Gisbergen has got the Midas touch today, and he now has the chance to make it level.
Well, Lewis Moody penalised, and he's a fine player going forward, but it's a real Achilles heel in his game, you know. He does concede penalties, and Martin Johnson, so calm in the early stages, lets himself go a little bit there, reacting, I think, to Delalio's mocking encouragement of the referee's decision to award all these penalties to Wasps. Eight in their own half, and can it make it 20 out of 20 for Mark Van Gisbergen? Tie it up.
He kept the angle. Now can he supply the 3 points? And for the first time in the match, when Van Gisbergen could have got Wasps even Stevens, he loses his form.
But it's been a fantastic start to the half for Wasps. They wanted to get territory to put Leicester on the back foot to work for these penalties, and they've done it ever so well.
Lucy through Gibson's tackle
again.
Yes, it was Lucy who was handing off Gibson to score the London Wasps try. And now, of course, they'll be wishing that they had gone for the corner, but life isn't like that. Van Gisbergen missing the penalty, and Gibson and his team back upfield and putting into this scrum on the Wasps 10-metre line, as you can see.
Once again, headstrong play from Josh Lucy. It's been a mixture of good and bad from him today.
Corey, Ellis, Good. And that is a good floater ball out to Lloyd. Lloyd goes against Abbotts, and Gibson now has had a spillage. Daryl Gibson, who's won Super 12 titles with the Crusaders and would love to win a Heineken Cup title with the Leicester Tigers. Good's pass, Stuart.
Well, he's cutting out Josh Lucy. They've gone over him with a boot. Now they're using the pass to cut him out. Again, it's training ground stuff. They've studied the tapes of Wasps. Sean Edwards says if they're good enough, our defence will be put under pressure. Leicester at times are good enough in attack today.
And Worsley was good enough at that line out to claim the ball. It was far from easy. Look at Shaw and Johnson. That was always going to be a centrepiece of the match. One you were never going to take your eyes off because of the size of the men. And now O'Connor. Oh, might have lost his shorts, but he hasn't lost the ball. No time for embarrassment for O'Connor and Wasps. Here's Shaw and here's King coming around to find Abbotts, and that's that Abbott jink. Hasn't quite managed to get away today, Stuart Abbott, but when he does, they'll have to work hard to catch him. Same can be said about Orinley. Dawson. Orinley arrives, so he's out of the picture, but there are still plenty of London Wasps lining up. Some of the forwards have joined the backs and vice versa as Orinley takes on the forward role. Good combative play by Orinley. Dawson, King going for the crossfield kick himself now, and this is interesting as Lucy tries to get there. Oh, and Murphy seemed to take Lucy out. He really did, and if he shakes his head, but my initial reaction to that one was that the Leicester fullback wasn't looking.
It wasn't malicious, it was still
to play the ball.
Okay, back you go.
There's nothing particularly malicious about it. He was never going to really harm Murphy, but Lucy was taken out in the air.
Well, that's pretty cynical to me. I think that's a yellow card. The bounce goes against him. Jordan Murphy just levers his chest into Lucy to take him out. And, you know, it's Lloyd against Lucy there. And I think Jordan Murphy is very lucky, not just for the infringement there, but for the fact that Leicester are constantly infringing in their own 22. A great chance. Now, some would call this audacity. Others might call it cheek. There you go.
Oh, dear. Well, it happens.
I thought Dowie was on the pitch for a minute.
I love the way O'Connor spent time just pulling up the shorts. Can't blame him for that. Here's Van Gisbergen. Just missed one. Didn't miss that one, though. Great bounce back kick from Mark Van Gisbergen.
It is, and a great comeback from Wasps. They are really starting to dominate this game in terms of territory, and they are getting the points they need. They're calm, they're composed, all the panic of the early 15 minutes or so gone. They are playing like assured champions of Europe at the moment.
O'Connor, fully dressed. Dawson. Lloyd is not that forward.
Away,
thought he had.
Leave it.
Murphy took it.
You thought right.
Stay, no.
Murphy took it in an offside position. I think it was accidental, but it was a knock-on.
Good. Voice leaves it. Van Gisbergen sort of says thank you and then goes down the line. Here comes Good to cover. Different issues now for Leicester, having seen that big lead disappear. Burkitt, King, Arinley, home crowd are going mad. Arinley can't get it out to Greening, but the referee's going to call them back. It's a knock on down here.
Well, it was Leicester so composed early on. You see, Andy Good made the decision to counter and run when you feel Leicester need to get some territory in Wasps' half. You can see now Wasps starting to dominate, a quarter of play in this half in the Leicester 22s, and they're coming away with a point. Leicester need to really start playing the game behind the Wasps pack.
We've both gone, we'll come around the other side.
Wasps being allowed to march forward here, and they've got the mental edge on this game now.
You may mention earlier in the match about the comeback against Munster last season, and London Wasps were never going to be counted out of this one, no matter how far Leicester got in front. And Johnny O'Connor has now started to play as if he's on fire. Dawson, King, Arinley, bit of space here, Voice, and now it's the Wasps backs with the ideas and setting the examination for the opposing defence. Delalio, a good strength, but even he was driven back there. Here comes Shaw, what will they do with him? Knocked on as Shaw tried to offload in that tackle. That's the weight of the tackle that caused that. Well played, Leicester.
Leicester just rattled. Harry Ellis could easily have been penalised there. We say Matt Dawson got away with one in the first half when the Wasps were rattled. Now suddenly Ellis, who played it on the edge in the first 15, he's the man. Lucky to get away with that. Young player of the year 2001-2, but this is quickly becoming a venue for old heads in this last 25 miles.
And a big learning curve for Harry Ellis, setting out still at the start of his career. He's achieved an awful lot, and he will achieve a lot more in the years to come. He is a star in the making.
Yeah, but
John Wells knows that, as you were saying, at times like this, it's the likes of Corey and Johnson and back, and you really start to see the influence of those players. Or you shorten Delalio too for Wasps. You can see there looking, checking what's on the far side. Gibson's been there with the All Blacks, and he's trying to work his way up the touchline. Neil back. to Goode, just inside his 22. Called by the referee as confirmation to the rest of the players. And Wasp will throw in.
But again, Wasp got their hands on possession, as they have for the vast majority of this second half. You wondered, did Leicester just ease off at 22-6? I thought about that at half-time, and I think the answer is no. Wasp picked up their game, and Martin Johnson, greatest English captain, but certainly of my generation, has got a lot of thinking to do here, because the Leicester scrummage was dominant, but they're not getting the pudding. They're not able to control the tempo of the game, the pace of the game.
And that is the story of the game. What a start for Leicester. Three tries in the first 90 minutes. Moody, Murphy and Corrie all crossing that line. And then, adding to the two penalties, that try from Wasp when Leicester were a man down. That might have been a contributing factor, of course. I don't think Leicester flicked any turn-off switch. It's not in their makeup, not in their style. Same for Wasp. Wasp were caught cold, but they warmed up. And here's Dawson. And there's Ellis getting in. That's good work from the youngster.
Well, that embarrassed Josh Lucy. Absolutely nailed by Ellis.
Sniping, and then the kick from Ellis. And this might embarrass Wasp. And it's all about the bounce here. And it's well taken by Worsley, who used his ample frame to get up there and bring the ball down safely for his side. Dawson. And this is Shaw is going to clatter into somebody. It's Andy Goode, who offloaded very quickly and wisely. Oh, and Corrie's going. Corrie storming. Penalty as well.
I'm sorry, we've got to get away quicker than that.
Wasp couldn't build a brick wall quickly enough. Corrie came at a rate of knots. But it was some brilliant play before from Harry Ellis. As with his try, a little fumble initially, but then... boom, three Wasp there to make the tackle. But the competitive nature of Harry Ellis is quite something.
Martin Corrie might well have been hurt in that move, and Leicester will not want to lose him. Oh, Harry Ellis, having just shown one or two signs of letting the pressure get to him. We saw the replay of him and Dawson. Here's an example of Ellis coming right back into the match and showing immense promise on Lucy.
Well, and then the speed to strip that ball, and watch what he does now. He's got the ball from Josh Lucy. He knows that Lucy, the right wing's out of position. Lovely little kick, and Joe Worsley bails the Wasps out with a fine piece of cover in play.
Quiet falls now for Andy Goode, who gets 3 points for Leicester and gets them back in front. Meanwhile, London Wasps are having to make a change, and it's at hooker where Ben Gotting will replace Phil Greening, who is injured and is being helped off the field. There you can see Greening goes, and Gotting, this promising player himself, very accurate when we've seen him perform for his side on a big stage as well. Here's Moody. You have to keep checking the scoreboard to see who's in front now. It's one of those games. It currently stands at Leicester, but for how long? Delalio, flag is up. And when Leicester got that 3 points, it was in fact their first visit to the London Wasps 22 in this second half.
Well, it hasn't been a seesaw game, has it? It's been a game where Leicester bolted out of the blocks, got a big lead. Wasps pegged them back, and then Leicester just get the lead again. Delalio, there you go, on touch, spot on from the touch judge.
Here comes Gotting. After his first throw, he gets his first run. He's tackled by Back, but then
you were tackled.
He got up.
He just got straight back to his feet. Is he
held? Delalio checking whether he was held. And referee clearly thought that he was, and that's a penalty which Andy Goode will consider as gettable again. He kicks from this distance on a regular basis, certainly in these conditions and off this surface, which once again is immaculate here.
Well, it's the chance for Andy Goode, and it was made by all the wiles and experience of Neil back there. Ben Gotting was coming across laterally, looking to unload to a big runner. Back picked him out, made the scything tackle. Gotting naively gives the penalty away, and now the belligerent boot of Andy Goode to give Leicester Well, a wonderful 2 minutes after what's happened for the last 25 or so.
This man possesses a boomer. Andy Goode for his side. European Cup kicking of the highest order from the Leicester fly half. Well, both kickers have been in scintillating form, Goode and Van Gisbergen, and that the latest example of that. Now London Wasps have restarted and the ball has gone right in the corner, and there's a consultation on that far side.
I've got a view of it. It came this side, okay? It's a touch here.
Okay. It didn't. It was this side, or playing side, if you like, of the flag.
This doesn't count.
Well, it's a brilliant
this
piece of play
count,
from King.
Okay? Look in the law. This counts. This doesn't.
It's out of touch. The right side from a Wasp perspective, the wrong side for Leicester.
And it's thrown over the top and taken by Johnson. Ellis, good pass, Goode. Big kick again, it's gone a long, long way. Look at that one.
That's very good play from Wasp. Rock solid. Shooter throws it to Johnson and he'll stand up to a black tidal wave. That's not going to knock him off his feet. And then Goode again using the power of that right boot to send Leicester 35 metres out.
Worsley.
Scrum.
There's a put into London Wasps. Now, we have a law to explain here. If this ball touches the flag, that is touch. If it touches the post of the flag, that's in goal. And that explains that particular law, and that explains why it was a line out and the ball hadn't gone dead. Leicester will put in.
So the flag itself, a marketing tool for the sponsors. The pole, part of the laws of the game.
Spot on.
Those 6 points look pretty important now, don't they? Because Leicester needed something to get them going again, to get a foothold.
Corey.
Release it, hands off!
Ellis, long pass for him, Goode. Had to stretch there, down towards there, his boots for it. I think the consequence was he was rather hurried into the kick. And it wasn't one of his best, and Van Gisbergen for London Wasps is now buried underneath that ruck. Here comes Lucy. And then it's Alex King, and he rolls out of the tackle. Just how London Wasps experienced life in the final against Toulouse last season when they were majestic in doing that, the French side. It wasn't enough to win on the day. Slip by Healy, big cheer by the home crowd, and Alex King has popped that one over Healy's head. Not sure Austin Healy would have had a view of it as he was down on the floor having slipped and turned, but it was a beauty again from King.
Healy could have been 10 foot tall and leaping, he wouldn't have got anywhere near that. That is arrowed with precision from King, but the Leicester line out once again, rock solid with Mr. Colossus there.
And went to Johnson that time. Ellis waiting, checking the offside against Shaw. Now he passes, that's much more where Goode would want it. And he plucks it down out of the air and then puts it out, but now it will be Wasps to throw in. Changes being made again by London Wasps. I think this time it is tactical. By the way, latest news on Phil Greening, we hear some ligament damage there suspected, so wish him well. Will Green is the man who will go off, and it's Ali McKenzie coming on. In the front row, of course.
Well, Ali McKenzie, perhaps not the experienced scrummager Will Green is, but again, he's a carrier. Wasps are 6 points down, they've got to take this game to Leicester, that's why he's on.
Delalio. Dawson, inside it goes to Boyce. Could have gone badly wrong, but it didn't. Dawson took the risk, it paid off. Knew what he was doing. King to Abbott, and Arinley hasn't really got himself into the match as an attacking force. Nearly did there. Penalty.
Calm down.
Dawson wants a word again. Johnson, no doubt, will
you're all
have
off
a word
the deck.
Too.
You can't interfere with the play. Okay, the ball was on. Scoop back.
Shot, Lewis. He's given the penalties when he sees it.
I love the way Delalio and Dawson had a discussion, third person, about the referee. Well, he's given the penalties when he sees them, Dawes, as if letting Nigel Williams know with an earshot, but you're not seeing all of them, are you?
And Dawson called the referee Nige. I like that familiar touch.
It's also friendly out there, isn't it? Martin Johnson, he's saying, what do you want afterwards? My shout, Lawrence.
What a fantastic match this has been. But all hush now again as Van Gisbergen to make the gap three again. Which he does. No trouble, regardless of the pressure of the situation. Warren Gatlin, can he bear that pressure? Nothing he can do from the touchline apart from make the odd substitution. And that is exactly what John Wells, his counterpart at Leicester Tigers, is about to do now. Alex Tuilagi being lined up for an introduction into this game for Leon Lloyd, who's come back from a long-term knee problem. Lloyd put himself about again today. Would not have started Lloyd had Saru Rambini been fit. But Lloyd didn't let his side down one little bit, never does. Worsley taking that restart, and he started to command those situations. King, Goode, Murphy. Van Gisbergen will take this in his stride. Read it superbly, and now he lengthens his stride. And Neil back, oh, well played back, got that off the floor, and Andy Goode with the left boot doesn't find his touch, and I'm sure that's what he was looking for that time. And Tom Boyce is going off his wing now, and the pace is relentless. It's as if it's the first 10 minutes and we're approaching the last.
Okay, hang on a second, skipper. Number 8 Green was offside. Do you want the penalty where he moved forward or the scrum where he kicked it from? Penalty.
He takes the penalty.
Number 8.
And as the storm grows in intensity, Martin Corey loses his composure, but the calm at the centre, Mark Van Gisbergen, another major kick for him. You remember at the end of last season, Alex King lost his kicking rhythm, Van Gisbergen took over and he kicked better and better under pressure. And now, Leicester could be made to pay. In the second half, 5 in their own half. This is within range. 12 minutes to go. In the way this game has gone, Mark, the pace of it, it's still an eternity, whatever happens with this kick.
Before the match, nobody could split them. And as we approach the final 10 minutes, this kick is to make it level again. It's been a kicking duel in this second half between Van Gisbergen and Goode. Neither giving an inch. John Wells calls for that last effort now, as both sets of players look to dig deep, and they will need a shovel.
Supreme technique and a temperament even better from Mark Van Gisbergen. This is about will, but it's also about cool heads now.
O'Connor trying not to get isolated. Delalio realised that very quickly.
Well, the penalty's being shelled out. You feel both teams will want to be in the opponent's 40-metre zone, don't you?
Dawson. Jordan Murphy. Lucy just about made the tackle. Shaw was with him, but Murphy made valuable ground there. Goode. It's Boyce. Let's play it, says Van Gisbergen. Let's go. It's kicked away back to Goode, and it's Leicester's turn to launch something from this situation. A fizzing pass from Goode, asking a lot from Tuilagi, and asking too much in the end.
And that's a poor kick from Andy Goode. He looked up, he wanted to go diagonally, but Watts had men there, and Delalio spurring his troops on. Both he and Martin Johnson have spent a career putting so much in to their single clubs as they have playing for their country. Fantastic examples for their clubs and club game.
Gotting. Burkitt. Gotting again. It's come off a Leicester hand.
It's come forward off green two.
And let's try and put this all into context. Leicester have already lost in this pool. They lost away at Biarritz. Can they afford another loss? Question one.
Well, possibly, yes, they can, but they must get a bonus point, because if they win both their home games and nick a five-pointer, they could win this. This game, this group could be won by a team with four wins and key away bonus points.
And London Wasps with this home game and with trips to come against Leicester at Welford Road, and then in the final match away to Biarritz, can they afford to lose this one at home?
No.
Come back to Stewart on that. Well, he's got in there. Couldn't resist it. This is London Wasps and King and Healy. Voices in front of him. Well, I'm not sure what else Healy could have done.
Keep the ball in field, Mars. Because I think that's a slice from Healy. He was under pressure. But I think it's better to just fire it 60 metres downfield. Simon Shaw down at the moment. But how about that kick from Alex King? We talked about Van Gisbergen's poise under pressure. The tactical kick of Alex King made something out of a speculative reverse pass.
Got him to throw. Wasps did have cover for that long kick. And they had men in that position waiting, had Healy
numbers
gone long.
In the line out.
And what he didn't want to do was risk the charge down there, right up in his face. It's a free kick. No time to dwell on anything in this match. Here's Delalio, and here are Wasps again, and here's Dawson, and the remainder waiting. It's out from King to a Ridley. Good tackling from Leicester. Picked up by McKenzie. The replacement almost there. Nearly squirts out the side. Wasps have another go. Lucy, the extra forward, he's the guard now to protect Dawson, who gets the ball out again. It's Worsley trying to burrow his way there. Dawson again, was that slapped out of his hand? The referee takes a look and gives a knock on.
5 metres.
And all manner of London Wasps players were waiting on this near side to create the overlap.
Well, that's amazing defence from Leicester. One more phase and the Wasps were in there, and by hook or crook, bootstrap hands, Leicester somehow made sure that ball did not come out.
I saw the punch.
Shut up. Down. Keep the binding up. Wait, no. Engage.
Ellis puts in.
Stay. Get round.
Little push now from Dawson. That's how the match started, the other way around.
Gone again.
And it also started with this scrum splintering under the pressure up front, and Julian White is still working in, and Roundtree with him.
Oh, what a fine scrum that is. Really solid.
Like an outcrop in that Leicester 22. And here is Goode sitting back in what they term the pocket.
That's really good rugby under pressure. They just put the wheel on there. Corey drove into King and then the clearance. But Wasps upset because they don't think there's a knock-on here from Dawson. There is a knock-on from Matthew Dawson. The referee is right.
There was a boot in there as well, actually. That was McKenzie doing good work again. There's a question of who that was in charge of that boot. I have a good feeling it was a Leicester sock. There it is. Kicked out of Dawson's hand.
Yeah.
Wait, touch and hold. No.
Final 5 minutes of normal time. And inevitably on a day like this, more points of debate than you would see in a week in Parliament. Here's Corrie.
We don't have debate in Parliament, so I'm with you there. What a last 5 minutes we've got here.
No.
Ellis.
Away black.
Back. Good. European chances could be resting on this next 5 minutes or so. We'll only know that at the end of this pool. Pool one when the draw was made. was screaming excitement all the way, and it will go down to the final whistle, this pull, there's no doubt. But will we look back at the end of it all and say this was the day when it was really decided? Time will tell. 31 points apiece.
You do feel Wasps need the win here.
Stay back! Back foot! Stay! Stay! Stay!
Referee checking Leicester in the starting blocks, but Dawson getting his kick away. It was Worsley who chased, and he almost got there. I mean, the tackle was made straight away, and as Nigel Williams says, the catcher had no chance whatsoever to get that ball away. There should be a Leicester put-in.
Green caught it, OK, from the catch, didn't have a chance to do anything.
Very commanding take. I thought that's a tremendous piece of work. It was a brilliant kick.
Murphy, wasn't it?
Yes, yeah, it's Jordan Murphy. He's up against Worsley. Worsley's the bigger man, but Murphy's made that his own. It's a top-rate kick from Dawson. It's an outstanding piece of full-back play from Jordan Murphy.
And the Leicester pack are going forward again. What's happening here? Penalty! Penalty, Leicester.
Straight down the field. The Blacks just disintegrated in the scrum.
Not for the first time, the Leicester pack have their say in this match.
Wow, what was Rob Howley saying at half-time? We've got scrum problems. Indeed, they have disintegration there. And again, Dowd is in all sorts of problems there. McKenzie on, and he can't do anything to stop it. And White, Roundtree, and those oak trees, Deacon and Johnson, driving on. And they've given a chance to Andy Goode. Over to you.
With Welford Road to come, Andy Goode might be about to snatch a win at the home of the European champions. And they can probably hear that cheer from the Leicester supporters back in the city, in the East Midlands. The supporters here, delighted with Goode, their man, and equally delighted with the performance of the pack to win that penalty. Now can Wasps come again?
That was an amazing kick from Andy Goode. Question marks about his temperament. Would he be the man to replace Jaco van der Vesthuizen? Wow, he's had a good game today. His goal kicking has been challenged by the brilliant kicking of Van Gisbergen. It's been a psychological duel, and look at those penalties. They have punished defenders.
Right at the start of the game, we made the point that it was going to be played at test match level intensity, and everybody had to be there, not even the cap players, the non-cap players as well. And Andy Goode, who's been around a long time in club rugby, it didn't work out for him at Saracens. He's always had a lot of talent, bags of talent, but is this the day when Andy Goode really came of age as a top level player? And by that we mean very top.
Well, he's had a fine season, but he cracked in Biarritz, but he has not cracked under the pressure today. This has been a solid performance from the 10. He's now back in the pocket, up goes the bomb.
The Gary Owen then from Andy Goode, but he's still not certain to end on the winning side here.
No, from the
same
kick.
Situation, isn't it?
Just the same as over there with Green. It's a scrum down, black ball.
Not too much to add on, we're hearing. A minute and a half, in fact.
Engage.
London Wasps may not know that. Here's Lucy. Didn't hear anyone ask the question to the referee, Nigel Williams from the Wasps side. Van Gisbergen has a little juggle with that, he's knocked it forward, and Leicester have the ball, they might have the win now.
Well, they have the scrum, the last scrum gave them the position for Andy Goode to kick the winning goal. Julian White, number 3, has been the destructive presence on the field. And it's the prop forward, Julian White, is my Heineken Cup man of the match, the spearhead of a Leicester scrum.
Andy Goode is going for the drop goal! The referee signals it's good! And Leicester now are seizing the initiative between the two English sides in this pool in the Heineken Cup. Goode has done it again!
Oh. The Leicester scrummage with their man of the match holding it, and Goode, fantastic behind them, strikes with a drop goal. Surely even Wasps are beaten now. One last chance.
Coming around!
And ironically, they're going to get a penalty, but 3 points isn't enough. They've got to go for the try. Referee signals next dead ball. The champions are on the ropes here. Abbott cutting back inside. Any mistake now, and it's game over. Alex King. Oh, it's Lucy coming through! Ridley gets there. It's out to King again. There's nobody in left wing position. Had to hold on to that. Dawson. Abbott! Leicester defending with their lives here. Advantage was being
Number
played.
Nine.
Was have another penalty.
Lazy run in Harry Ellis. And Pat Howard cannot bear to look now. It is going off again.
Fight off the ball here. And that could only distract everybody from the matter in hand. But again, it's how the game started, and it's how it's going to finish, and it's how it's going to continue into next week. But we'll deal with next week when it comes.
Delalio is calling for a penalty try. I don't think Nigel Williams is going to give that, but the touch judge is in.
Try line. Next dead ball.
Oh, strap yourselves in, Mars.
Next dead ball then still. That was Dow going. This is O'Connor. Man on the wrong side, penalty. Referee has to stop to think about the penalty try for repeated infringement. Needs to be pretty well certain a try would have been scored though. Dawson demanding another penalty.
It was on if it was quick.
Dawson still waits. Plays it now. King, where's he going? He's slipping, he's falling. Referee's blown his whistle again.
Please, if there's another penalty, okay, this goes to the line, I'm going to go under the post.
It will be a penalty try next time. Final warning given to Leicester. It's down to Delalio. Can the captain do it? It's loose.
Release.
Leicester think they've got it. Bodies all over the place. Dawson's got across to the referee again.
Everybody's on the deck.
It's not a penalty. It's the final whistle. And the Leicester Tigers put their armour on. They came to the home of the European champions. And the hard shell of Martin Johnson's team in the end could not be cracked. And in this champion pool, it's Leicester who strike here in a most momentous Heineken Cup match. It was the pool match with everything.
An unbelievable game of rugby. Lawrence Delalio talking to Nigel Williams. But I was just looking at Shooter, White and Roundtree together. Leicester used to be ABC, but today 1-2-3 have done the job. Andy Goode was magnificent with the kicking. No tries in the second half, but just as compelling as a magical first half. The Heineken Cup, smouldering for 2 weeks, has ignited. That was a great, I repeat, a great game of club rugby.
And now it's Wasps and Biarritz who have to go to Welford Road into the Tigers' den to scrap for their survival.
Well, now Wasps have it all to do, and Leicester, with the vital away win, must now be favourites to come out of this painful pool.
And a match which was played at such intensity is ended by mutual respect between both teams. They will meet again next week, and we all hope that next week goes as quickly as any other week in our lives. Can't wait for the next encounter between these two. And this is what it means to the Leicester Tigers to have won here against the side that won the double last season, the English Premiership title and the European title as well. London Wasps have a lot of hard thinking to do this week. Johnson will try and rally his side again, but they will be back at home, back at Welford Road. And they won't get that reception when they run out next week.
No.
This time for the London Wasps supporters, as Leicester stay out there. It was a breathless, epic match, right up there with the very best that we've seen in the pool stages of this competition. Greatness should be reserved for very few. We saw two great matches last season, didn't we, with Munster Wasps and Toulouse Wasps. And I suppose because of the stage of the competition last year, they will rank that little bit higher, but take nothing away from this game. And these players gave an awful lot. Back to you, Simon.
Thanks, Miles. Exceptional. What a game of rugby. It simply doesn't get much better than that, does it? Leicester with a big early lead, but Wasps kept coming back at them, the mark of two outstanding teams, slugging it out for the full 80 minutes. So what it means to the table is this. It means it's a three-way race, doesn't it? Wasps lead the way by a solitary point from Biarritz and Leicester. But I suppose this result now means that Wasps are going to have to go to Welford Road next weekend and upset the odds.
They certainly do, and it's a game they have to win. It's a must-win game. All the clichés will come out again. And, of course, they've got to go down to Biarritz as well. So, yes, it's as simple as that. But that was a fantastic 80 minutes. Credit to Leicester. They came out initially in the first half, blitzed them with three tries. But Wasps, you know, it's not a foregone conclusion at Welford Road because they will be hurting from this. You know, there's a little bit of controversy, maybe. You know, they were asking for a penalty try.
Do you think it was? I mean, well, repeated infringement, was it? I mean, Dawson was screaming for it.
Repeated infringements in the last couple of minutes, and I think that, you know, whether the referee should have gone underneath the post. But for us to come back from 22-6 down, yeah, we showed enormous self-belief against a very good Leicester side. To go up there next week, that won't daunt us in any way, and we look forward to that trip, and it'll be another cracking match.
Mm. OK, let's get down and hear from the Leicester captain, Martin Johnson, plus the man of the match, Julian White. They're talking to Graeme Simmons.
Simon, thank you very much indeed. Irresistible forces, immovable objects. Does it feel right now, Martin, so you've just loosened one of Wasps' hands from the Heineken Cup?
Not really at all. They're champions still, they're not. We'd lost one already, they hadn't, so it was pretty key for us to win today. Strange game, you know. We scored really without getting in the 22, I think three times. We just cut them open, and then for about, you know, the rest of the game we hardly had the ball, and we got on the wrong side of the referee. We got frustrated with some decisions. We couldn't impose ourselves, made silly mistakes and let them dominate territory, and they kicked penalties. So it was frustrating, actually, in that we didn't really play much rugby again. I think 2 weeks ago we didn't play a lot of rugby. When we did, we looked like we could open teams up. But, you know, we just handling errors, silly mistakes, trying to force things, kept them with territory. And as I said, we nearly lost our composure a bit. Refereeing decisions occasionally were frustrating. Sometimes it was silly penalties from us, just as they did when we attacked. But look, it's about winning it at the end, and we kept the composure in the last 10 and nicked it.
It was shock and awe for the first 15, 20 minutes. Were you surprised at how well you started out?
Yeah, I mean, of course, if you score, we get three tries in 15 minutes or something. And we just, you know, some great fair play. You know, Ollie's been out for a while, Leon's been out for a while. I think the first two times he touched the ball, he put a scoring pass in. So the guys look incredibly sharp. It's just frustrating we didn't get them much ball after that to show what they could do. And whilst immediately we're back in the game kicking penalties. So we were never, you know, although the lead may have been maybe 15 at one point, they got it back pretty quickly. And disappointing in a lot of ways for us to concede. I don't know how many penalties they kicked, but, you know, we don't normally concede that many penalties, contrary to popular belief. We try and be very strict around the breakdown. But, you know, if it is a penalty, it's a penalty, and you've got to get on with it.
Julian, the scrum was key today, absolutely key, in the pressure that you put on Wasps. How closely have you identified that area before the game coming in as a point of attack?
Well, obviously, they've got a strong scrum, but it was no different to any other game. We knew that if we could get, parity there, or, you know, exert ourselves, it makes things easier for the back. So, you know, we talked about it during the week, but it was nothing that we focused on any more than we would do any other week. It's about sort of getting that scrum going forward. Sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. And like today, we worked well. Myself helped having Jono behind you. So no, it was a great win.
How sweaty was it getting at the end, Julian? Were you worried that the referee might go under the sticks?
Well, exactly. I mean, we were all sort of panicking towards the end there. It could have been a very different result. So it was sort of all hands to deck. You know, we were all just trying to jump on somebody and slow that ball down. And, we got the win. So, like I say, probably wasn't the prettiest game towards in the last 10 minutes, but, you know, we got the win that we wanted.
Do you feel, Martin, now that you're very much in pole position in this group? I mean, I know it's tight, but you still have got Barits and Wasps, your two closest challengers, both at home now. If you can shut out the games at home, you're there, aren't you?
Yeah, but the thing about playing an English team, we're not travelling to France, you know, then we've got to come an hour and a bit up the motorway to play us. So I think the home advantage thing from Europe is not quite so big. So I remember one year we beat Toulouse away and then lost to them the next week at home. So, I mean, you know, they're the English champions and the European champions, and just makes next week's game even tastier in a way. They'll be a bit disappointed today in the way that things went. But no, you know, I think it's very, very close. And as I said, if you can nick an away game, that's great, but you've still got to win at home. And we've got two very, very good teams at home and a difficult trip to Italy. So we're just looking for no further than next week, as the saying goes.
Good cliche to finish with, Martin. One last job for you to do before you go. Julian White, Heineken Cup man of the match. Well done to you. A presentation is in order, I think. If you've got the strength to hand it over.
Very well played today.
Thank you very much, Martin. Pleasure.
Beautifully done. Thanks very much. Alongside here is Lawrence Dallaglio. Let's start with the end, Lawrence. Should there have been a penalty try?
Well, I don't know about that. 31 all. We are camped on their line. Matt Dawson's had the ball kicked out of his hand. That is a penalty. Referees have judged it to be a knock-on by him. And
that could be human error, though. But, I mean, at the end, did you feel the referee should have gone under the post? Did he say to you he was going to if it happened again?
No, because it would have been a big call. I mean, they certainly could have carded someone. Six. I mean, you know, we all know the score. You know, we're over a try. You know, we're a try in front. And you just do anything to kill the ball until the end of the game. And that's all Leicester did. In fact, that's what they did for most of the game, in fact.
You've done it a few times.
Yeah, absolutely. But they got penalised for it. And, credit to the referee, because he did penalise them. And we just kept chipping away at their score. But unfortunately, we got ourselves back to 31-all. We had the field position. And, didn't give the penalty. They came up the field. We gave a soft penalty away at scrum time. And really, if we're honest, the scrum is what's cost us the game. You know, they out-scrummaged us, caused us problems. Missed a few tackles. First 20 minutes of the game, you concede three tries. You really are asking an awful lot. I thought we showed a lot of character to dig deep. This contest, in terms of the group, is far from over. I'm sure you'll recognise our pedigree as champions of both competitions. We'll come up we'll come out with a point to prove next week. They're a quality side, we know that. But they won't have it easy next week.
Love to talk more, Lawrence, but we're flush out of time. Good luck to you. Thank you very much for coming through. Cheers.
Great honesty by Lawrence Dallaglio. You have to admire him for that. They were out scrummaged this afternoon. Is that something you'd go along with?
Yeah, in attack and defence. And obviously it gifted Leicester field position and also gifted them the winning points in the end, which, Lawrence is an honest guy. And they'll work hard this week. And hopefully we'll see a different result next weekend.
It sets up a cracking game, doesn't it, next weekend, Dowie?
Oh, fantastic. Can't wait. I mean, we saw some great endeavour out there and honesty from Lawrence Dallaglio.
Yeah, I think on the day the better team won, all we had to do is look at the team sheet and who scored. You know, Leicester scored three tries to one. The only reason one of the reasons that Wasps stayed in the game was Leicester's indiscipline. That's something they'll have to work on during the week. But yeah, Lawrence was right. The scrum was Leicester were just all powerful, all game there, and really benefited from that. And some nerveless kicking from Andy Good at the end.
Mm. The two best teams in England at the moment, that is shown by the relative positions in the Zurich Premiership. On that evidence, the two best sides you've seen so far in Europe?
So far, I think with the intensity of that, all right, Leinster were very good yesterday, but who were they playing? Basically, Bourg-1 seconds. Stade, Francais, you know, they're hot and cold. Toulouse losing to Northampton. Yes, you would have to say. These are two fantastic quality sides with, you know, the ability to beat anyone on the day.
You've been there in that Wasps dressing room. What will Warren Gatland be saying right now and in the build-up to next week?
I think he'd be disappointed. Disappointed the fact that a silly penalty cost us the game. I think that 22-6 down. We didn't give Leicester that bonus point, which could be crucial coming next weekend. Because if they had that bonus point this afternoon and we would have gone up there, it would have been a hard afternoon. But thankfully stopped them and let's play next week.
That's all we've got time for, I'm afraid. I'm going to have to stop you there. We're looking forward to next weekend. Remember, you'll be able to see highlights of all 12 games. If you missed anything over the weekend in our European rugby special, that's tonight from 9 o'clock on Sky Sports 2. And just a reminder that the Varsity match on Tuesday from 1 o'clock on Sky Sports 1. We'll be at Twickenham for that one. My thanks to Michael, thanks to Dowie, and thanks to Rob as well. Leicester nick it from us all here. Bye for now.
Turn me around.